there are over 18 million diagnostic errors in the U.S. alone every year, some of which may be associated with adverse patient outcomes, even death. With patient outcomes as a key driver in the laboratory, in vitro diagnostic testing has become more efficient over the years. But complex processes and human errors can delay reporting and introduce unwarranted variations. Hi, I'm Haley Mancini, coming to you live from the floor of the American Association of Clinical Chemistry's annual meeting, where we are learning how digitalization is helping to reduce errors. Let's talk to Saper Sayedzadeh, head of global marketing in portfolio management, automation, and digitalization, to understand how.
Hi, Saper. Haley.
Thank you so much for talking to me today.
No problem. Nice to meet you. So today, new technologies are producing more data than ever before, and we are able to aggregate millions of these data points from siloed sources. Digital technologies can use these data to enable smarter diagnostics processes that can ultimately reduce operator bias and subjectivity. Let's just give an example for today. Today, we can aggregate data from the patient background, from the analyzer status, such as QC, and take into consideration things like laboratory standard operating procedures or even the physician's requirements or preferences, and apply sophisticated algorithms to evaluate the result based on this criteria. Those results that meet the criteria are automatically validated and sent to the physician, so essentially standardizing the clinical decision-making process. Only those few results that require operator attention are brought forward to the operator with a clear task for them to take on, essentially saving time and effort.
So time is saved and errors are reduced.
Exactly. And what's interesting is that in the background, the systems are intelligently monitoring the process to be able to predict the potential bottlenecks that could impact the process. So for example, if an emergency sample turnaround time is being delayed, the system can proactively notify the operator about it so that they can take action. Or for example, if an analyzer's onboard reagent lot number is about to expire during the middle of the run, the system can proactively notify so the operator can resolve those bottlenecks before they actually happen.
So today, clinicians are getting patient results from multiple and disparate sources. How is digitalization going to impact that?
Suppose smart algorithms and artificial intelligence can actually integrate these data points and be able to provide a succinct report for the physician. But what if artificial intelligence can actually compare the patient's laboratory and radiology results versus a large population of patients? In a matter of seconds, the physicians will have a holistic view of the patient's clinical status. Specific patient-centric clinical pathways could be proposed, which ultimately results in patient care be vastly improved.
Well, thank you so much, Saper. I really appreciate you taking
pleasure.
The time to talk
thank
to
you.
Me.
Thank you.
Fewer errors, digitalization, and AI are revolutionizing diagnostics. To learn more, click on the links below.